Good afternoon, everyone. We are here to give a OOSP presentation, and our topic is swings. So, what are swings basically? We are all familiar with AWD, right? People as AWD. So, swing is just an advanced version of that. So, swing, as we the swing is the GUI building toolkit, and it was created by JFC, that is Java Foundation class. Now, as the name suggests, GUI, so it provides a graphical user interface to the Java applications. So, what was the need of creating swings? I mean, we have AWD, so at least swing is an advanced version of AWD. Like, it provides a more sophisticated GUI tools that was not present previously in AWD. Like, the look and feel of the look and feel of the Java applications become more awesome, I should say that. Previously, we have only buttons and labels, and with the help of swings, we have introduced trees, graphs, so to provide a better graphical visualization of the application. Now, swings are lightweight. So the term lightweight means that they are platform independent. They are written entirely in Java, and they are also independent of the GUI of the client interface. Right? If you are applying, if you are having a swing application in the Java, in the Linux or Windows or a Mac OS, so it will provide a symmetrical interface for all, which was not present earlier in AWD. Right? So that's why it's called lightweight. Lightweight terms means it is available for all interfaces without providing any external software. Previously for AWD, we need for some external plugins so that we can use it on every possible machine. Now, swings further, they are further been replaced with JavaFX. It is a more advanced version of the swings. We are not going to use JavaFX. Now, databases. Databases are actually storing user information. We all go through several applications throughout the day. The information that we enter in that applications or our personal data that we enter, that is stored in the database. So database actually stores all the data that we enter in that applications. Now specifically JDBC, that is Java Database Connectivity. It is a GUI tool, for it's an API that provides the client to access the information present on their servers. Right. Now, JDBC is a Java application, so it is platform dependent. So, more advanced feature of JDBC is that it is also database independent. We have different types of databases. I mean, different type of databases. Like we have MySQL, PostgreSQL, and Oracle. MySQL and PostgreSQL is an open source, and Oracle is a commercial database. So JDBC provides a uniform connectivity for all three of these. Now, how it provides the connectivity? So here it is a diagram. So first we have a Java application. We enter our details in that. It passes through a JDBC API. Now JDBC API further transfers to JDBC device. Drive manager. So this is an important part. Drive manager. We have different drivers for different type of databases. So according to the request, it transforms it provides the necessary driver for the different type of databases. Like we have a different driver for Oracle, MySQL, and JIIT. Okay. Now difference between AWD and Swing. We have previously discussed that AWD is a platform independent. Right? And Swing, these components are platform. AWD are platform dependent, and Swing is a platform independent. AWD are heavyweights. That means they depend on the client's GUI. That means different type of systems will have to provide different plugins so that the AWD application can run on it. While the Swing have a uniform GUI, that means different systems will have to provide different plugins for running the Swing application. Now, AWD have less components than Swing because Swing is more advanced than AWD. So the advanced feature of this is AMD doesn't follow MVC model. MVC model is a model view controller. The model view controller, it represents the model represents the data, view represents the presentation, and the controller provides the interface. So in the AMD, they are not able to connect our data with our database, and which is not possible with the JavaScript. But these are some terms and interfaces through which JIIT operates. Now first, the driver manager. Driver manager is a class that handles different type of drivers, and it provides the necessary driver which is acted by the database. So if we have different type of databases, so it provides the necessary driver that the client has requested for that particular database. Okay. Then matches connection with the request for the Java application with the proper database driver using communication sub protocol. Next we have the driver. Driver, it communicates what it communicates, sorry, it links the database with the application. Now the important part of driver is that we do not create the object of the driver. We create the object of the driver manager. And this is because the working of the driver is been abstracted. It is not shown to the user. And we cannot make the objects of the abstract class. Therefore, we make the objects of the driver manager, and it provides a way driver needed for that application. Now, connection. Connection, this is the interface that physically connects the application with the database. Now, for, connection, the connection objects represent the communication context. Therefore, all communication with the database is made through the connection object only. Okay. Next is the statement. The connection does not directly correlate with the database. It needs some statements like the SQL query and all. So the statement objects passes the SQL query to the database. So it links the request of the server with the database. So the charge like this: the first request is sent to the driver manager. It sends the appropriate driver. Then the connection is made by the driver, and through that connection statements are passed. And after that, SQL query is been operated, result set is been formed. Now, result set, it is a tabular data in which our information has been stored. Right, if we enter our username and password over a web page, so it gets stored in a tabular data which is not visible to you, of course, and it is visible to the client that operates the database. Now, at the last, we have SQL exception. We have exceptions like for exception handling. For the database, if we get some problem with that, we have some PDF exception that is handled by the class SQL exception. How to create a JDBC application? For creating a JDBC application, we have 6 steps. First, we have to import the package. Then we have to register the appropriate driver according to the database. Then we have to create a connection. Then we have to open a connection. We have to execute a query and extract the data from the result set and then clean up the environment. So let's have a moment. So first register the JIT. Sorry, first import the packages. Now import the packages as you all have studied earlier. Import.java.sql.sar means all the classes in that particular package will be called. And next is register the driver, JDBC driver. A driver has been, as I have told before, it is according to the database for which we have been using in a client service. So it requires you to initialize the driver so you can open a communication channel with the database. Now to register the JIIT driver, we have two methods, like get class.forName and driver manager.register driver. And here and further in the code we are using class.forName method. And it operates very easily by the try catch exception handling as we have studied. The try class for name, and this is the name of the driver, that is oracle.ddbc.driver.oracle-driver. These are the different driver names of the different databases that we have. Right? For MySQL, we have com.mysql.ddbc-driver, or like that, as I told before, db2. That database we have com.ibm.db2.jdbc.net.db2.driver. Then we have Sybase, we have com.sybase.jdbc.sybase-driver. Now the connection, that means creating a physical connection between the database and the application. So for that we use driver.driver-manager.getConnection. So it starts a connection and gets an appropriate connection according to our database. Right. Then we execute a query. As I told before, queries are executed by the statement object. So whatever we pass through the statement object, it gets transmitted to the database, and further our result set is calculated according to our query. Next step would be extract the data from the result set. To extract the data from the result set, we get result set dot get. Now get is written as XXX, so it depends on which data you want to extract. Like you want to extract the username or password or different. Actually, in the result set, the data is data is present in tabular form. Like we have different tables for username, we have a table for password, we have a table for further information. So in this the get XXX, we will have to provide what type of data that we want to extract. And next is the clean up environment. This physically closes the communication so that our server may not be able to access the information which we don't have to provide. Okay. Now Shivam will tell you how to create a form and further.
So you know all about the basics of the Java strings. Now we will learn about how to create a form using strings. So registration form, name, roll number, gender and code are all labels. These two boxes are the text fields. These are the window buttons, out of which only one can be selected at a time. This is the combo box and this is the submit button. The package used for creating the form is java.swingx. So now we are using the Java package, but here we are using JavaX, which is the extension of the Java. So Swingx is the extension of the Java, as the AWT is the basic, is the base. So JavaX Swingx package provides a set of lightweight components that works the same on all platforms. Classes which underlies Swingx package are stack buttons, J buttons, button groups, J component, and J frame. Now J frame is basically a container. JFrame, the class JFrame, is an extension version of the java.awd frame that supports the string component architecture. So JFrame is a top level string container. It provides the support that the string component need to perform their painting and event handling. So now we will learn about different components. So first of all, JLabel. JLabel is a display area for a short text string and or image or code. So it is only for read text. So we import the different packages that are used, Java from Swingx, all classes of Java Swingx, import AWT and event and AWT. These two packages are also used because the Swingx uses AWT infrastructure and event management. So public class mylabel is the class name, extends JFrame. This is the syntax for creating the JFrame. For creating the JLabel, this is the class name JLabel. L1 is the object name, and we have this is the string tag. This is string which will print on the label. Similarly, other five labels are also initialized. Add L1 and add functions add the label to the JFrame. Set layout will set the layout of the JFrame. If we want to position the labels by ourselves, we have to make it well and pass the parameters x-axis, y-axis, width and height in the set bound function. Otherwise, we can pass either the type of label layouts. Set visible function is a component that makes all the components visible in the JFrame. True is either here Boolean expression is passed. If true is passed, then it will be visible. Otherwise, if false is passed, then it is not. Next component is JFieldText. JFieldText is used for taking input of a single line of text. It can be editable. We can edit the text and we can fetch the text from it. Same packages are imported from it. For this, myTextField is the class name for this and extend JFrame. The syntax for JTextField is JTextField class name, JTF is the object name, and the parameter path is the number of columns. You can pass also sir string name and both string name and the number of columns. Similarly, JTF is added to the table and the layout is null, and we have passed the position parameter to position the date expiry into JFrame. And set size is to set the size of the JFrame, which is height and the width. Set width and same. Next, say radio button. Radio button is a group of related buttons in which one can be done, only one can be selected. It is used to create a button frame in place. It is widely used in quizzes or exam patterns. Same type or same package is imported. And the syntax for it is J radio button. Class name, R1 is the object name. And in here, the string is class main. Add function will add this to frame. Set layout null. Similarly, all the functions are same. JCombo. Combo is a combination of text fields and drop down list. You can click on the drop down list and the list will appear, and you can click on any item. So here the list array is initialized, string code equals to CSV and DC. This is the list which will appear in the combo box. And JCombo box, JC equals to new JCombo box course. Here parameter pass is the array, and so when we add this to the frame, it will appear. This is the combo box, and EC and CSE are the parameters. This. J button, it allows a button to be created using item, a string, or a board. J button supports action event. When a button is pressed, an action event is generated. Public text field extend J frame implements action listener. We have to implement action listener for action. J button PT equals to J button submit. This is the string text which will be printed on the button. And this is the BT dot add action listener. This refers to the same class object. So it will disable to the brain. Public void action performed action event T. And BT selected J option page. J option is a component which will show a dialog box. Whenever the action is generated, action event is. So after execution of this J option paint dot show message, a dialog box will appear showing successfully registered. So by applying all these components, we can form a form. We can create a form, but we can also create a form by such a simple method that has been used in the NetBeans. That is palette. We can only drag and drop the component from the palette onto the frame, and the code will automatically generate. We have to only write the code of the button of the action listener action, that is action performed. And select a component, select any component in the palette, move the cursor to the design or the structure view, and click wherever you want to add the component. You don't have to pass the positions of the component. Panel, it is a lightweight container. Scroll panel, it allows you to scroll horizontally and vertically. Split pane allows you to split the pane into two compartments. Labels will be on load, buttons. Toggle button, it defines two functions, on or off, and it's. So now Shivam will explain about you JTBC as a connector.